Hello everybody, this is Twin Yawgmoth, but you can call me Simon. Protoman, who apparently kidnapped Dr. Light as seen in the intro, is now in reach as we killed his 8 goons and stopped his plan to take over the world. It's time to assault his giant fortress shaped after his helmet that nobody noticed him build over the last 2 years. Right. And boy, he couldn't have chosen a color scheme less vomit-inducing, could he? Anyway, I haven't really found a good way to deal with those tigers at the start, so it's buster time. This first jump here is actually really hard to get right, so be on your toes. Oh, Gravity Hold, the weapon we got from Gravity Man. It hits everything on the screen and sends them off flying if it kills them, which is fun and also really great because, as said, it hits everything on the screen. Sadly, we won't get a drop from them. Oh. Ah, too late for the Star Crash here. So, this guy here will jump if I hit the B button. So, why doesn't he? Even if I charge up the Buster, the trick is holding down the B button after getting out of the start menu. So this one here, I have to lure because of that problem. Oh, and respawn hits again. Fortunately, I've got Charge Kick, which is built for that situations in my opinion. This guy here though, just unleash the Buster and you're gold. What's coming up now is a room with guys on the ceiling who want to get the drop on us, which would be a really hard challenge platform-wise if we didn't put them, send them straight through the stone. Don't ask me how that works. You fall down here, which is an easy jump to miss too. You get greeted by some tigers, so be on your toes. You could also use Super Arrow here, but it takes about the same amount of ammo, and I'll use Rush Call here too. A word on him, I really don't mind the change from the old Rush Call, which had the spring at the top, because, well, it gives you something more to do than just hop on it and you're good. So, why not? Anyway, the next screen I'll use Gyro Attack a lot, but I'll really advise against it because your weapon energy doesn't get filled up during the Fortress Rages, and it's the most precious because the most useful weapon. So, what we've got here is an impassable pit, if not for Rush Chat. Problem is, if Rush Chat hits the wall, it will disappear immediately, so jump at the end. This outcropping here can really fuck you up. Power Stone, on the other hand, will not in the next few seconds, because, as I noticed here, there are a lot of enemies, and it is bound to hit something, which is nice. Problem is, if you're trying to hit something, it won't, so away it goes again. Well, nice try. So, Water Wave is tailor-made for situations like that. You get ambushed by bullets. Water Wave stops bullets, easy as that. So, the next section I'm gonna cheese a bit with Super Arrow because I'm not in for dealing with crappy hitboxes. Like this guy has. And it's fun to see him so useless in his small little pit there. Next section I could easily cheese with Super Arrow, but I won't. This is a return of the infamous block puzzles that plague every Mega Man. I hate them, and many others do, but fortunately they're only in those two rooms. The first one is easily dealt with, just jump, but here you gotta wait. For this block, and then his, and this. It's quite easy if you know the pattern, but if you jump too early you get fucked in the right side of the room, which is not fun. So, another refill area, just before the boss. You really have to conserve your weapon energy here, even if the weapons kind of suck. Gravity Hold especially takes lots of ammo, and well, you could use it on those guys, for example, but you'll never kill them because they're really, really resilient, and they go away after a while too. So just ignore them; they'll never hit you. I'm using Water Wave here because the Mega Buster for Bosses rule is gone for the Fortress stages. It was meant to be to show off that you could really beat the bosses in any order you like, and this guy here is about as simple as a garden hose to kill with Water Wave, you know. But it's a ground-based weapon, he'll never leave the ground. That's why I use Charge Kick here, and I was really surprised when I first tried that it actually worked. You can see his AI isn't actually meant to deal with this kind of abuse, and well, he smelled the rings and I haven't broken a sweat. In reality, all he does is get faster after half health, and that's about it, so. But if that boss was unimpressive, just wait for the next one. Fortunately, the next boss is really unimpressive because it follows the hardest stage in the game, in my opinion at least. So right at the start we greet you with a choice. What if we go right? Well, there's nothing there. Thank you. No. Actually, there would be an M tank if I didn't have one. So, great idea to refill there. This next section would be great for gravity hold if it didn't have that much limited ammo. Actually, it's really, really good to use gyrotech here. That means I love using gyrotech here. Thing is, if you want to conserve it, you can also do this with the Mega Buster and a bit of patience. That is all. Just hit those guys when they're alone, and not let the as seen here, the trains get on screen. They will actually explode when left alone too long. Suicide trains, funny. Anyway, what follows now is the hardest stretch on this level, and many a casual playthrough of mine ended here. The conveyors can easily send you in the pits, and the flying enemies don't help at all. StarCraft is a god's end here, because it can deal with their bullets, deal with them, deal with everything. As you can see here, the problem is, if you get a refill in mid-air, it stops the game for a second, and can really fuck up your timing. Anyway, it isn't that hard, but, well, insta-kill is never fun. So, I will take a few seconds here, because I'm stupid, so I can elaborate at the while on the fortress stages themselves. The thing is, I really like how they are designed. Every level has its own unique feel to it. They're never not fun, they never get boring at all. They're quite long, but also rewarding in a challenging sense. The music isn't that bad, it's all great. The problem is, the game doesn't end with them. There are more stages afterwards, spoiler, there is Dr. Wily involved, and those are really, really bland in comparison. So, we'll just enjoy what we've got here and make the most of it. So, I didn't want to fill up Super Arrow here, but man. And the Napalm Bomb didn't quite reach. As you can see, the balls the machine shoots out can actually be used to refill your weapons, because every one of them can drop something. If you want to, well, use it. Don't know why that buster doesn't charge up here, I do not notice it until now. Well, charge buster shot would have killed that guy. You have to keep pressing left immediately after getting the E-Tank. The life up is easier because while the game is stopped you can get it. Can use Super Arrow up there to get the life, but I won't because why should I? So those guys aren't actually that easy to hit because of well timing, but gyro attack it makes it impossible to not hit them, which is swell. As you can see, if you shoot it and then just press upwards when it's under them, you'll never miss. Those guys here are a bit of hassle if you don't remember, like me, that you can shoot their bullets. Just use a buster here. Or, as they take 4 buster shots to kill, 2 crystal eyes will do. I found this out, as you might have noticed, in Gravity Man stage. This screen here is the hardest in the level, enemy-wise. It's not the pits, it's the tigers. So, I don't go up there and let powers don't do the job. There are many ways more efficient, but none safer. As you might have noticed, it took only 2 power stones to kill, because I've used 1 gravity hold on it. In a few seconds you will see why this is relevant. The homing dudes are really, really inappropriately placed here, as you can see. They're always in situations where you cannot hit them at the start and you will have to wait for them. So, I just use gravity hold here, and as you can see, it actually deals damage. You can kill the tiger with it alone, which is good. You can also let the tiger jump in the pit, though. Well, I didn't notice that until a later playthrough. So this boss here is the least impressive boss in Mega Man history. It's also the worst designed and generally the crappiest ever. His weakness is Crystal Eye, as you can see here, and well, that's about it. It's like 2 seconds in and I've said everything there's to say about this boss. Wait a second, he gets faster at half health, like his predecessor, and actually it's the same guy. Took a few seconds to adjust at the start, but afterwards, well, he's like Charge Man, but without the invincibility while the charging, without the coals, without everything. It's just absolutely simple. He just walks at you. I just don't get it. Anyway, after 2 stages, I think we've spent quite a lot of time on this, and I'll see you in the next 2 stages of Proto Man's Castle. Thank you for watching, and I hope you've enjoyed.